Triumph Bonneville is the name given to an iconic motorcycle from Triumph Motorcycles. It's named after the Bonneville Salt Flats in the state of Utah, USA, where Triumphs, among other marks, made successful attempts on the world motorcycle speed records. The original Triumph Bonneville was a 650cc parallel twin motorcycle manufactured by the Triumph Engineering Company Limited and later by Norton Villiers Triumph and Triumph Motorcycles Limited, the workers' cooperative. The first production machines rolled off the line on the 5th of September 1958. They were based on the Tiger 110 model and fitted with that model's optional twin carburetor cylinder head, twin Amal monoblock carbs and remote float as standard. The E3134 high performance inlet camshaft was also fitted with Lucas K2FC red label magnetos on the USA models. Initially produced as a pre-unit construction and fitted into a single down-tube frame, it could comfortably achieve 115 miles an hour without further modification. The same engine configuration continued through 1960 to 1962, but with a new duplex frame comprising twin front down tubes in the construction and new petrol tank and seat arrangement. The 6-volt dynamo had been replaced by an alternator and the usual Lucas magneto still powered the ignition system. This series finished in August 1962 and although criticized as not one of the best Bonneville types, remains one of the most sought after. From September 1962, a radical new Bonneville was produced with still the same capacity and T120 model designation, but now with an all-new unit construction engine and gearbox fitted into a new stiffer frame, reverting back to the single down-tube arrangement. Steering head angles had been altered with new front forks with springs on the outside, making a better handling machine. The electrics were now taken care of by two sets of contact breakers in the timing cover, driven by exhaust camshafts. By 1968, twin leading shoe front brakes were standard, as was a 12-volt electrical system. Arguably the Bonneville of choice, this model continued in production until very late 1970. In 1969, continuing in the quest for speed, Malcolm Uphill, on board a T-120 Bonneville competing in the Isle of Man TT races, riding in the production machine class, which was the first to do a 100-mile-per-hour lap with an average race speed of 99.99 miles an hour. 1971 saw the introduction of the BSA-designed oil-in-frame Bonneville. This series had a difficult birth. Initially, there were problems fitting the engine into the frame, which were quickly rectified. This model is also referred to as the High Boy, alluding to the seat height, which was easily 2 inches taller than the previous model. Prior to the end of the T120 model, Triumph had developed and introduced the T140V Bonneville model, which ran concurrently with the T120. The first T140V models were larger in capacity, offering 724 cc's from the 31st of August 1971, followed on the 11th of December 1972 with the full 750 cc's. The oil in frame, as its name suggests, has a large 4-inch diameter central spine made from 600-ton tensile steel tube, which also doubles as the oil tank for the engine. The capacity is reduced from 6 imperial pints to only 4. However, because the surface area of the tube is greater than the previous oil tank, the oil temperature is actually cooler. Standard equipment by now was disc front brake, followed in 1976 with rear disc and left-hand gear change. This was the start of the wholly produced cooperative-made machines for the 1976 model year, commencing on the 10th of July 1975. Specifications continued, but now screw thread forms had been further amended to the new UNF series from the previous CEI type on the cylinder barrel. The opportunity was also taken to produce a special version of the T140V to commemorate Queen Elizabeth II's Silver Jubilee. It was resplendent in silver, red, white and blue with chromed engine covers and built as a limited edition, designated T140J Jubilee. The T140V by now had to meet strict emission controls, and a new derivative, T140E Emission, became the standard for the 1979 model year, through to the Meridian Cooperative finally closing its doors in 1983. Various other specials were built during this period, the most significant being the 1981 Royal Wedding to commemorate the wedding of Charles and Diana. This was made in two styles, USA in blue and chrome, and Home General Export in black and chrome. Another development was the electric start, which was available from the 26th of March 1980. This was not really the best design, and it had some very expensive teething problems for owners. Finally, it was fairly well rectified, but must go down as one of the contributor factors in the closure. The last thing to be built and recorded in the records is T140W 8-valve engine on the 24th of April 1983. John Bluer bought the intellectual rights to Triumph Motorcycles, and to keep the name in the marketplace, he leased the manufacturing rights of the Bonneville. The 5-year license was granted to L.F. Harris Limited, previously trading as Racing Spares. The license was specific as to what could be built and what was basically the 1982 140E previously made by the cooperative. However, negotiated in the deal was the opportunity to improve the suspension, brakes and source components from other markets. To this end, some of the parts sourced were Brembo brakes, Pauli suspension, Magura controls, steel fuel tanks and silencers. L.F. Harris set up the manufacturing plant in Newton Abbott, Devon, and produced the first Devon Bonneville in 1985. Production ran for the next 3 years, finishing in 1988 with over 1,257 engine numbers being recorded. There was a very wide choice of colour schemes available to purchasers. These bikes were sold to over 20 world markets, with 180 going to Japan. While L.F. Harris no longer produces motorcycles, the business continues as one of the major suppliers of Meriden and Devon spare parts, and it's still situated in Newton Abbot. Sadly, Les Harris passed away earlier this year. The Royal Signals, the White Helmets display team, have been using Triumph motorcycles in their displays for over 70 years and currently use a fleet of 30 Devon Bonnevilles fitted with single carburettors and other specific modifications to suit their routine. The current bikes were assembled in 2000 and they've been in constant use each year all over the country. In April 1997, meetings were held to discuss the viability of a new twin-cylinder Bonneville. By summer, the concept had been agreed and the chassis and engine design team started work on the new bike. Moving forward to August 1998, the first styling review of a full-scale three-dimensional model was undertaken, together with input from sales, marketing and engineering departments. The second major review to assess the changes followed the earlier feedback, and that occurred in November. The prototype engine is run on the testbed for the first time in December 1998. By March 1999, the engine was installed in the prototype chassis for the first time. Following this, full-time testing got underway. The first six development bikes were built in July 1999. Four were used primarily for engine testing and the other two for chassis test work. The sales and marketing teams had the final review to confirm the Bonneville production model styling and specification in September 1999. With the completion of final testing in July 2000, the new bike was signed off and was launched in September 2000 at Intermot at Munich in Germany. This was the start of the 790cc Bonneville, and it became a well-respected addition to the Triumph model range. Following on from its launch in 2000, there were more diverse models based on the twin-cylinder engine, forming the Cruisers and modern classics now in Triumph's range. In 2002, Triumph celebrated its centenary and chose to launch two centenary editions. One of these was the T100 Centennial Bonneville. The new bike had a special Lucifer orange and silver paint scheme and it was fitted with accessories as standard from the range. It also sported the Triumph Centennial logo on the front mudguard and side panel. The new launch also saw the Bonneville America make its debut. This was a completely new design around the twin-cylinder engine, but with a twist. The firing order was changed from 360 degrees to a more cruiser-like sounding 270 degrees. New frame and wheels, forward controls, and the Cruiser was here. For 2003, another cruiser model, the Speedmaster, was introduced to give another dimension to the range, and the T100 became fixed as well with two-tone paint scheme and tachometer. The Cruisers having the 270 degree engines. The others had the 360 degree engine, with all having a capacity of 790 cc's. The model range was selling well, but there was an opportunity to introduce a more sporting Bonneville for 2004. Taking its name from a previous racing version, the Thruxton was introduced. It had a new 865cc engine with more power, sporting handlebars, more length on the twin rear shocks, and a lean sporting look. Harking back to the 1960s and the American influence, Triumph chose to make the Scrambler for the 2006 model year. This was a high-exhaust, on-off-road Bonneville featuring a two-tone colour scheme and revised steering angle. It was fitted with the 865cc engine, which by now had also become standard in the America and the Speedmaster, and having the 270-degree firing order. The range now consisted of Bonneville, T100, Thruxton, America, Speedmaster and Scrambler. The next year, 2007, saw a standardisation of the engine capacity to 865cc's for all models in the range, but still with two firing orders. The 2008 season was set to see another significant improvement as fuel injection was introduced across the range to meet current and future emission regulations. It's now 50 years since the first T-120 Bonneville rolled off the production line back at the old Meriden factory. Triumph have continually improved an already good machine, and for 2009 added two more bikes to the impressive lineup. First is the Bonneville SE. It has cast alloy wheels, finished in Pacific Blue and Fusion White or Jet Black. The edges of the wheels are polished and the spokes picked out in black, resembling the Leicester wheels fitted to the 1979 T140D Bonneville Special. It also has a lower seat height, due in part to the 17-inch front wheel now fitted. The final Bonneville for 2009 is the 50th anniversary limited edition. It's painted in the same colours as the original Tangerine Dream T120 from 1959. This time, the colours are called Meriden Blue and Exotic Orange. The original capacity of the Bonneville was 650cc, and so, in respect of this, there are only 650 of these models made. Each has a brass plaque on the handlebar mount, proudly displaying their number. It's fitted with a unique black seat with white piping and the Triumph logo in gold on the back. Chrome cam cover and 50th logo decals on the side panels, supplied with a certificate of authenticity signed by John Bloor. This is surely the most fitting way to celebrate 50 years of this icon, which is the Triumph Bonneville.